I travel around Japan with my radiation devices because Japan decides to dump radioactive water into the sea.
Fishery products from parts of Japan have been banned.
Beijing is protesting against Japan's plan to release more than 1 million tons of treated radioactive water.
So I went around the whole of Japan and even ate fish near the power plant to see how the dumping of the radioactive waste has put us innocent tourists at risk. Come, I'm testing radioactivity in Japan's tap water. The radiation is 3 times higher than Singapore! So, what does it mean to drink tap water which contains radiation 3 times higher than Singapore? The fishes here are caught in the ocean which is situated in the north of Fukushima nuclear power plant. And the fish I'm eating has radioactivity! This is the most insane comprehensive experiment and effort made to determine if eating Japan's nuclear radiated fish or drinking radiated tap water is safe. Japan, the third largest economy in the world, is so beautiful that it attracts 22 million tourists every year. It's so damn beautiful and so many mind-blowing experiences, from the scenery to the food, that make you want to come back every single year. This whole mouth-watering set could have cost me 3 times higher back home. Japan is also home to a lot of cute animals. Close encounter and touching them makes any girl's heart melt. Except for this rabbit, very jiao lo. But the recent news have damaged Japan's reputation. I'm here to seek the truth for you. Of course, it helps that I got my master's in public health in NUS. I traveled over 2,000 kilometers in Japan from Osaka to Tokyo, northwards to Fukushima, into the exclusion zone, as well as covering 2 different seasides near the exclusion zone. And then all the way south to Kyoto and onwards to the mountains of Wakayama. All the way west to Hiroshima Ground Zero. I have covered every area needed to test for radiation. Nobody has covered the vast distance as I have covered to test for radiation in Japan. I'm testing radioactivity in Japan's tap water. The radiation is 3 times higher than Singapore. This is Osaka, Kyoto, Tokyo, Fukushima, Hiroshima, Kobe, Wakayama. I traveled to so many different places using 2 devices to reduce error, only to find out that Japan's water radiation is similar to Singapore's environmental radiation. Yes, there were some spikes, but spikes occur in every country including Singapore. Is this a bad thing? No. Let me explain radiation to you like a 5-year-old. Every day, you are exposed to radiation from the sun, from the rocks, from the soil. An average city measures 0.1 to 0.2 microsieverts of background radiation per hour. Eating a banana measures 0.1 microsievert. Going for a dental x-ray is 5 microsievert. That is 50 times more than eating Fukushima fish! To take this experiment one step further, I ate raw fish at every prefecture that I visited in Japan. I had so much sushi and sashimi every meal for the last 1 month, measuring radiation every meal I had in Tokyo, Osaka, Fukushima, Hiroshima, Wakayama, all the ma. But I'm still alive. The mainstream media is lying to you. Japan's sashimi is delicious and safe to eat. To take things to the extreme, I decided to eat at the fish port north of Fukushima power plant. As the sea current traveled northwards, I chose to eat at the 2 closest ports to Fukushima. This is the freshest fish that I've ever eaten in Japan. It can't get any fresher than this. In the morning, the boats go out to fish and bring back the fish to the morning market, where the morning market sells the fish to the store and we eat directly from the store. I even went to test the seawater for radiation, but all I could say is the seawater here is safe and the seafood here is safe to eat. Japan's sashimi is delicious and safe to eat. The only place in Fukushima that measures higher than normal radiation is within the exclusion zone. I will share with you some more shocking discoveries. The radiation that is worse than this, and it's near you. For example, taking a flight. As you fly nearer to the sun, radiation increases. At about 20,000 feet, the highest radiation could go to 0.5 microsievert per hour, more than 5 times higher than ground level. At cruising altitude of 35,000 feet, the radiation count is more than 1 microsievert per hour. It's like walking into Fukushima exclusion zone. For a better understanding, here is a visualization. From eating a banana to visiting Fukushima exclusion zone and taking a flight. A dental x-ray measures 5 microsievert. Now guess the radiation level for a CT scan. It's 7,000 microsievert! Here is an illustration on how bad it is. It exceeds my screen! Going for a CT scan is equivalent to 3 years worth of background radiation. The next finding is the scariest of them all. Look at how much radiation a smoker's lungs carry per year. Scientific research have shown that the radiation dose of a smoker's lungs is approximately 80,000 microsievert per year. I'll put the links of the resources in the description box below. Concluding this video, Japan is very safe. In fact, I think Japan is safer than Singapore. Why? If I were to drink Japanese water versus Singapore water, I would drink Japanese water anytime. Dr. Huberman talks about the effect of fluoride causing thyroid issue. I'll put the link below. The standard concentration of fluoride in water is 0.5 mg per liter.
0.5 milligrams per liter.
Singapore's tap water is 0.7 mg per liter. 50% more! This doesn't make sense. I would highly recommend the authority to reduce fluoride content. Dealing with a dirty teeth is easier than dealing with thyroid problem. I know a lot of people around me are having thyroid problem. Do you? Back to Japan. I highly recommend you to visit. It's stupid not to come. It's safer, cleaner, and cheaper. The Japanese went above and beyond, and you can learn by yourself by visiting educational sites like this school. I went through so much trouble for you, I would appreciate a thumbs up. See you in the next video!